Praise God that you chose my father, that you thought my father was worthy.
We are deeply shocked, we are deeply hurt, and since we have come to know the cruelty with which this took place, I am deeply saddened. And still my prayer and desire is that these people who took my husband's life will be touched by that same love, so that they will never do this to any other person.
Graham Stewart Staines was born in Brisbane, Australia in 1941. As an adult, he decided to visit India for the first time in 1965, and he joined the Evangelical Missionary Society of Mayurbhanj, working in the remote tribal areas of Odisha state, which had a long history of active Christian missionary style work. He took over the management of the mission at Baripada in 1983, after helping to establish the Mayurbhanj Leprosy Home as a registered society in 1982. His aim was to serve lepers and share God's love. In 1983, he married Gladys, and the couple had three children, Esther, Philip, and Timothy. Philip had the heart of a missionary. He loved and served people. He'd provide first aid to his friends when they were hurt. Timothy, as early as 6 years old, would write and sing songs. Graham tried to learn the local languages of Odia and Santali. Not a very well-known fact about Graham is that he played a big role in translating the Bible into the local Ho tribal language. He was a personality who always remained aloof from controversies. He lived a very normal lifestyle. He would ride a bicycle to villages around, providing medical aid to lepers. More than talking about God's love, he demonstrated what God's love is in action.
Graham Staines dedicated 34 years of his life caring for leprosy patients in this remote district of Mayurbhanj in Orissa. To all the patients here, he was their elder brother. For Padma, who came here as a 10-year-old, Graham was a father.
Graham Bhai brought me here from Rairangapur. I had very bad wounds and my parents had abandoned me. Graham Bhai took care of me. He was like a father to me. He gave me medicines and cured me. Now Didi takes care of us like a mother. Though Graham Bhai is not around, we lack nothing. Didi takes care of all our needs.
The faces of these men and women brighten up as they see their Didi or big sister. They know they are secure and cared for. But for Gladys, it hasn't been easy filling in Graham's role.
On the night of 22nd January 1999, Graham Staines and his two sons had attended a jungle camp in Manoharpur, which was an annual gathering of Christians in the area to discuss their beliefs in a social setting. They elected to spend the night in Manoharpur, sleeping in the vehicle due to severe cold at the time. In the early hours of 23rd January 1999, while Graham Staines and his two minor sons, Philip and Timothy, were resting in their jeep, they were attacked by a mob of about 50 people led by a Bajrang Dal member by name Dara Singh, who suspected Mr. Staines of carrying out forced conversions to Christianity. The windows were broken out of the jeep, gasoline was poured on and ignited, and the jeep enveloped in flames. The charred bodies were found embracing each other. Gladys Staines, in an interview soon after the incident, said, "It is far from my mind to punish the persons who were responsible for the death of my husband Graham and my two children, but it is my deep desire and hope that they would repent and be reformed." Gladys and Esther have decided to keep Graham's calling and vision alive, forgiving the men who carried out this gruesome attack. In Gladys's words, "We have forgiven the murderers, and that forgiveness healed Esther and me."
I mean, I miss his companionship, just being able to talk things over with him. I miss him not being around for Esther when Esther needs guidance, because he, as a father, had a lot of wisdom. Just that empty feeling of not having the children, not having Timothy particularly, because he was with me, Philip was at school, just coming and giving me the spontaneous love that children give to their parents. I really miss that.
Precious lives brutally brought to a close. But Gladys does not for one moment doubt God's faithfulness in her life. She knows that she is not alone.
Well, the Lord has been my rock and my fortress even before Graham died. I've been through several experiences in life where I've known that God has been there with me.